So here's our binary search tree, and we're going to look at the insert operation. The insert operation is going to prioritize in keeping all of the nodes in the tree exactly where they are. So what we're going to do is we're only ever going to add a node at the leaf as a leaf in the tree. So say I want to add the number 5. What I'll do is I'll compare that to the root, which is 50. 5 is smaller, so it must go in the left subtree. I'll continue recursing down this left subtree. I'll look at the 30. 5 is still smaller than the 30, so it must go in its left subtree. I'll look in 30's left subtree at 20. 20 is still bigger than 5, so it must go in the left subtree of 20. I look and there is no left subtree of 20, so I'm going to place the node 5 as the left subtree of 20. Again, I'm going to look at inserting a node. I'm going to insert the key 31. Again, 31 is smaller than the root 50, so I'm going to look on the left subtree. Now it's bigger than the root 30, so it's going to go on the right subtree of 30. It's smaller than 40, so it must go on the left subtree of 40. It's smaller than 32, so it must go on the left subtree of 32. And 31 goes right there. The important thing to remember is that whenever we insert a key into our tree, it's always going to become a leaf in the tree. So we never rearrange anything. It always goes to sort of the lowest spot and fits itself as a leaf in that tree. Again, if we tried to insert something that was already in the tree, say we tried to insert the number 60, we wouldn't actually add anything. Now we'll look at binary search tree delete. There are going to be 3 cases. The first case is if we're trying to delete a leaf in the tree. If we're deleting a leaf in the tree, it's really easy. We can delete it and there's no reason to change any other part of the tree. So we could delete 20, or 36, or 65, 75, 85, and the structure of the tree won't change. Just the node that previously pointed to that tree will no longer point to that tree. So that was the case if I was deleting a leaf. If I'm deleting a node that has one child, so you can see 32 has one child, 60 has one child, 40 has one child. Let's look at a single one of those. If I'm deleting the node 32, what I can do is I can simply replace it with its child, and now 40 will point to 34. And we'll remove 32. This still maintains the binary search tree property because everything in the left subtree of the node 40 is smaller than it. Everything in the right subtree, which doesn't have anything, is bigger than it. Let's look at another example. If I remove the node 34, again, the node 34 only has a single child. What I can do is I can remove this node by just pointing its parent to point to that node's child. So we just skip over the 34. Again, the binary search tree property is maintained. Everything in the right subtree of the 32 is larger than it. This is always going to work. Whenever we're removing a node that has only one child, we can simply point its parent to point to that child. The more interesting case is the third case, where we're trying to remove a node that has two children. Consider removing the node 70. What we'll do is we'll find the thing in the tree that is next biggest. The way we can find the thing that's next biggest is we'll look in its right subtree, because everything in its right subtree is bigger than it, and the thing on the very far left in its right subtree, so that's this 75. What we'll do is we'll replace the 70 with the 75. So we remove the 75 and put 75 as the new key here. Observe that this still maintains the binary search tree properties. Everything in the right subtree of 75 is bigger than it. Everything in the left subtree of 75 is smaller than it. Another thing to note was that this node 75 was really easy to remove. It was easy to remove because it had no children. However, let's look at trying to remove the node 30. Again, we'll try to find the thing that's just bigger than it. So we look in its right subtree, and we'll follow paths all the way to the left. And once we find that a node has no left, there's nothing over here, that means that it must be the smallest thing in its subtree, because there's only things to its right, and everything in this right-hand subtree is bigger than it. So whenever we replace a node, here we're replacing 30 with 32, we know whatever key we decide to put in the replacement to the key we're removing, we only ever have right subtrees. We know this because if it had any left subtrees, that would mean that there were some nodes that were smaller than that in its subtree, and we would actually use that node or that key to replace the value we're deleting. So in summary, when we're replacing a node like 50, we're going to look in its right subtree for something just bigger than it. So the smallest thing in its right subtree, that'll be 60 in this case. We recursively remove the smallest thing in its right subtree and then take the key at that node and replace the key we were originally trying to remove.